A quick tutorial for our Equipped for Good Work study through the book of Titus. We will be using blueletterbible.org, and so I just wanted to show you how to navigate this system to enhance your study. If you just type in blueletterbible.org in your search engine here, it'll pull you up to a home screen which looks like this. When you get to this home screen, what you want to do is just type in Titus, very simple, and then you can pick the version that you want to study in. We're going to be studying in the New King James Version, and you just simply push search. This will take you right to our text in Titus chapter 1. To navigate to the next one, you can just put 2, or you can also just switch gears here to the next chapter by using these buttons here. For our first week, we'll be in Titus chapter 1. A few buttons I want to show you. This button here will switch it to paragraph mode if you just want to simply read, or you can go back to the verse-by-verse version, which is good for studying and looking up words and all of that. Now, this button over here I love because sometimes I'm just tootling around the house and I want to listen to my text for that week, and I can pick which version I want to hear it in, and it will go straight to
Titus chapter 1.
So you have that as well. Anytime you get lost, you can just go to this home button and it'll just take you back to ground zero and you can start looking again. Now, for our study, you will be using this tools button, which gives you a lot of different tabs here. When you push on the tools button, and I'm going to go to verse 6 to show you an example, it will give you the two we'll be using the most of is the interlinear, and we'll be using the commentaries tab. Interlinear is where you're going to get your definitions for the words that you're used to, that you're asked to define. So here I'm going to use the word blameless in our example. You can get the Greek pronunciation. You can have somebody say that pronunciation for you, and you can switch and go to the word itself. Now on this page, it will give you the root words, how to pronounce the word. Down here, it will give you a Vine's Expository Dictionary entry. It will give you the total count of the times that it's used in the, how it's translated that way in the Bible. This is a Bible usage definition. This is the Strong's definition. So when it asks for a Strong's definition or biblical definition, these two sections right here will give you a very good understanding of what that word means. Now, later on in your study, it'll ask you, hey, can you give me a cross-reference for that particular word? On this same page, if you just keep scrolling down, it'll show you concordance results. That will give you every single other verse that particular word is used in. So that is good for cross-references. Now, another question that is asked is if you will give a cross-reference that means something different. In this situation, you can look at your antonyms for that word, and it'll make sense once you go through the study. You look up an antonym for blameless. Let's say one of the antonyms is guilty. You can push that right there in your search button. That will bring up all these verses about being guilty, and there's lots of them. And you can read them and pick the one that you see think fits best. So another button that we'll use, and this is your go back a page button, another button that we might use in our study, go back one more page, for this particular thing. And to get off this, if you're just tired of it, you can just simply push the tools button again. It'll take you back to your text. Let's say we're going to, on the section of list two or three things from the commentary. We use David Guzik's commentary, so you click on the commentaries tab, go down to David Guzik, study guide for Titus 1, and it will open up for you all the studying he's done, all the thoughts that he has. He's going to break it down. He's going to just extract things from the text for us that we will be able to look and study and get anything that we would ever want from his commentary. Now, David Guzik has his own app, so if you're app savvy and you prefer to use that, you can go on and download his app of his commentaries only, and use that as well. So I just wanted to give you just a quick guide through our text and through how to navigate Blue Letter Bible. I hope that was helpful. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask your group leader. Refer back to this particular video to help you navigate. The more you navigate, the better your study will be, and the better your study will be, the quicker you will learn the doctrine of the Bible.